Hi there. Welcome to the channel, Salesforce Emily. My name is Jeremy Call, and I am 11-time certified Salesforce Solution Architect. In today's video, we'll be doing a high-level overview of Apex triggers. I'll show you how to write them, their syntax, and how to understand and interpret the code. Let's get started. And to get started, make sure that you are logged into your Trailhead Developer Playground, and you'll want to follow along in a sandbox environment. Once you have successfully logged in, you'll find yourself on this page. And to access the developer console, you do so by clicking developer console in this top right cog. You can either click this right here and it will open in a new window, or what I typically like to do is right click and open in a new tab. Now that we've opened the developer console, we need to create a new Apex trigger. To do so, go under File and select New Apex Trigger. Here you'll be prompted with the name of the Apex trigger, as well as the S object or the object that this trigger will be running on. For this example, let's call this Apex Trigger example and have it run on the account object. Then go ahead and hit submit. After you have created it, you'll notice that Salesforce has helped make the bare bones of this trigger. First thing I want to do here is add some additional lines of code. I'll be explaining what everything is and how it works in just a moment. We need to add a for each loop to this trigger. So let me type that out. All right, now that we have the trigger written out, let me dive into each of these different areas and let's review the components of the trigger. First thing here is the name. You'll see the name of this is Apex Trigger Example. You can see the name up here as well. And if I were to change this and hit save by doing Control S, you'll see I've actually changed the name of the trigger. I'm gonna go ahead and delete that, change it back. Save, and we'll see I've changed the name there again. The second item here of the trigger is the object that this is happening on. You'll see that this is on the account object. The next part of our trigger tells us when it should run or be triggered. In this example, you see that this is a before trigger happening before the insert event. You'll commonly hear triggers as being described as before or after triggers. The before and after events are referring to whenever Salesforce saves a record. If your Apex trigger needs to access record ID fields or system audit fields like created time, then you'll need to use an after trigger. The events that can initiate your trigger can be a comma separated list. Here you see this is just a single value here. Although it wouldn't make sense for our trigger, you could add the different parameters like, for example, there's before insert, after insert, before delete, etc. The main thing I want to capture here that you can add multiple criteria for what starts or what would cause a record to enter your trigger. So I'll go ahead and delete that, and now we'll continue on to this next item here. This is called a for each loop. A for each loop repeats all of the code within these brackets for all records that enter the loop. And it turns out that trigger.new is a collection variable. And if you're not familiar with what a collection variable is, it's a group of multiple records. The account variable is temporarily assigned to the current iteration's record and performs whatever logic has been written. For this example here, we are simply assigning the account name field to big business account. Once this iteration is completed, then the trigger will loop through all of the records that have entered the trigger. And there you have it, a high-level overview of the syntax and an explanation of everything within the trigger and what it does. If this video was helpful, please leave a like and subscribe. Let us know if you have any questions in the comments, and thanks for watching.